Tonight we're going to cook some trout that Clayton caught over west of Fort Dodge in a little pond. I'm rinsing them off. These have been in the freezer, but they're just as good frozen as they are fresh. Almost as good. Fresh are the best, but I like to spread the fish open. Make sure we clean them out good if any little blood or anything is collected there. And then I like to spread them so they will cook, because these are nice and fat. And you want to make sure they're cooked through. Open it like this so it'll cook up into this thick part. Usually if I'm cooking salmon or just a smaller portion of a fish, not a whole big fat one like this, I'll just do one side and then the other side. But these take a little longer to cook through because they're so meaty. We're ready to pop them in the oven. I've turned the oven on to high for broil. I've moved my shelf up to the top part. Here again, I'll show you how we're up on the this top shelf of the stove, and I've got it onto high broil. And I'm going to cook that for about 5 minutes, and then we'll flip it on each side for about 5 minutes. So I'm going to set my timer. I'm heating some oil here on the top of the stove, and we're going to have some sweet potato fries along with it. If we weren't using the oven for fish, we could bake them in the oven, but I just think as long as I'm cooking the fish in there, it's better just to go ahead and cook them in a little grease, a little canola oil on the top of the stove. Okay, now I'm going to put in some of the frozen sweet potato fries. You can use fresh sweet potatoes and cut them up yourself if you want to, but I was just running a little late tonight, and so I decided we'd just use the frozen ones we had that were already cut. And I have about 2 minutes left on this side of the fish, and so you have to kind of try to judge when you need to put the sweet potato fries on to cook. Put them in frozen, and then it takes a little bit for the grease to heat back up again. But they're coming along now. All right, I'm gonna take the fish out now, and we're gonna turn it over on the other side a little bit. Look like it's getting done.
Looks great.
All right, well, we're just about finished. Okay. I've done it for 5 minutes, 3 times, and I've turned it. I started out with it spread open, then on one side 5 minutes, and then on the other side 5 minutes. So I guess that you could say 5 minutes on 3 sides. Everything's kind of coming together all at once here, so we're going to have to hurry and get our frying off, because the fish look like they're getting a little bit browned, and I think they're done, and so we're going to take them out maybe a couple minutes before the last 5 minutes, so you need to judge that yourself as you're doing your cooking. So there's our fries are ready. And now here comes our fish. Oh, and they're looking yummy. Excuse me for reaching in front. All right. Now, which one would you like to have, dear?
The back one, yep.
And I'll bring over my plate. They look very good.
So what I've done here is just taken and just run the fork down the middle, and then you can just take and lay the skin back off the fish like so. Get rid of all the skin. Then we come on one side of the rib cage and open that up. Oh, and that's hot. And we'll lay our fillet off of there.
I can see the steam coming off.
And you can see that it just comes right apart. We've got the whole bone coming out of it. Add a few beans, and there we are.
Big smile on your face.
Okay.
You're wiggling around too much.